Minister for Communications and Works Mark Vantepoel says the UK government is, quote, not a big bad dog, end quote, and expressed his pleasure with the current relationship between the governments of the United Kingdom and the Virgin Islands.
We have to, at all times, at least get their advice, let them know what we are doing, get their sign off. Even if you go the route we are going now with the Port Authority, we have to get the UK sign off on it and have them come through what we are doing. So we have to present our case, let them be comfortable, and get the agreement that we can go forward in this manner. So we are preparing for that and want to work with them closely. But they're not a big bad dog.
Minister Vantepoel was responding to questions from host of JTV Spotlight Edwenka on Tuesday, October 1st, on the heels of an announcement by Premier Dr. Orlando Smith that government had severed ties with Tortola Pier Partners for the expansion of the Rotang Cruise Pier and Landside Development Project. The statement explained that Tortola Pier Partners failed to conclude the conditions precedent to the agreement in a timely manner. That announcement gave rise to suggestions in some circles that the UK government may have influenced the decision taken by the local authorities.
How confident are you that they will support this new move that the government is making?
I'm relatively confident that they will. I think it's the business deal that we're putting forward in terms of how it's going to be structured with the cruise lines involved and the guarantee is going to, give them some level of comfort. And I think they will realize that what we are doing will, and the way we are doing it, will benefit the people of the Virgin Islands even more. We don't have to share our revenue anymore. And hopefully they will agree to that. And the revenue that we will achieve from this project will accrue, ultimately all of it, to the people of the Virgin Islands. And I think they will be willing to support that.
Tortola Pier Partners was expected to invest $60 million in the project and a further $20 million into the community over the life of the project. The agreement was also expected to guarantee 425,000 passengers yearly. The Communications and Works Minister says government is working on the same deal with Norwegian Cruise Line and Disney to bring 425,000 cruise passengers each year. Minister Vantepoel disclosed that Tortola Pier Partners will be paid for works done on the cruise pier expansion project.
It was very clear to all of us. We've made some agreements, a heads of terms, and the agreement said that at a certain time, 90 days later, if Tortola Pier Park Group did not meet the conditions precedent, the government could have just said, thank you very much, goodbye, gentlemen. The government said, okay, after those 90 days, we give you another 30 days. After those 30 days, it weren't ready. We said, thank you very much, goodbye, gentlemen. No strings attached, no conditions. They weren't met, and therefore we just walked away. Now, we made provisions that in the event that this happened, that the time that we spent, to be spent on engineering drawings and architectural drawings and planning and so on, that time won't be lost. That was an agreement we made. That time won't be lost if the negotiations break down. But whatever drawings or whatever work was done, and we had a list of them, and we agreed prices for each one that came to $1.7 million. And once they can produce to us each of those items, with the value that we have for those, we will pay for it. So it's not a penalty or anything like that. It's, in fact, it's what we wanted, and we are glad that we made that agreement early before.
So buying these things from them, these works that have already been done, will save you the time, save the government the time in having to do them over again.
Yeah, because we would have to pay for that. We would have to go and hire people to do them anyway.
Okay.
And perhaps even a higher cost, who knows. But the main thing was that we'd have lost a lot of time to get them done.
And since you're not changing the plans to such an extent, these still can work.
We just adapt them.
You just
adapt them to the project.
Well, that's a little.
So there's no penalty for walking away.
Government and the BVI Port Authority are now pursuing talks with unnamed financial institutions to secure financing to proceed with the cruise pier extension. Projected to cost some $25 million, as well as the landside development element of the project. Vantepoel says government is committed to ensuring that various sectors of the BVI economy benefit from the project.
We are very confident we can get our locals involved. We need this project urgently to help to stimulate the economy, and we don't need it to give to outside people to stimulate the economy, you know. We need to give it to locals to stimulate the economy. So, and that's what we're doing. And even on a total payback group, we were stipulating that the work be done locally, and it was going to be very clear. They were aware of that. They had already started consulting with locals on the matter if they had to go that route. So we were very clear that we wanted to make this project positively affect the local economy, even in, as you said, in terms of materials from companies. Mm-hmm. And I hope that we can gear up to have the local suppliers meet with these, whoever's going to do the buildings, and negotiate prices and make agreements so that we can get the local economy stimulated, both from the worker level and from the supplier level, that we can get a lot of stimulation from this project.
The extension to the cruise pier is necessary for BVI to accommodate the larger cruise liners that are now sailing Caribbean waters and to increase the amount of cruise passengers coming to the BVI. Minister Vanderpool says the BVI will benefit from an increased cruise passenger tax, which will change next year from $7 to $15 per cruise passenger.